everybody. Today we are going to discuss Fry's rearrangement. Fry's rearrangement is the conversion of aryl esters into ortho and para hydroxy ketones by treating with Lewis acids like AlCl3. Consider one of the finest examples of it. Phenyl acetate, which happens to be the aryl ester, when treated with AlCl3, then we receive ortho hydroxy acetophenone and para hydroxy acetophenone. As far as mechanism of this reaction is concerned, what happens? AlCl3, being electron deficient molecule, it is an excellent example of Lewis acids, so ultimately tend to attack on the electron rich oxygen. Now, oxygen bear lone pair of electrons. Due to this, an intermediate so obtained which can be written as, so AlCl3 attaches itself in this way. Now from this point, what happens? This oxygen ultimately gets attacked, therefore it bears positive. Now being electronegative, this holds pair of electron from this bond, due to which acetylium ion get departure like this. Now at another end, what happens? Chlorine with electron pair get also removed in the form of chloride ion. So acetylium ion and chloride ion at the same time get departure, I mean get removed, due to which an intermediate so obtained which can be represented as, now this intermediate further get attacked by acetylium ion. Now the attack of acetylium ion takes place at ortho and para position. So we may receive two different intermediate products which can be represented as, this can be the ortho substituted intermediate, and now another intermediate which happens to be the para substituted. Now these two intermediates are now needed to be hydrolyzed in order to get our product. If this is hydrolyzed, then ortho substituted product is obtained, what we call ortho hydroxy acetophenone, and on hydrolysis of this we may receive the para hydroxy acetophenone. It's what all about. So in Fry's rearrangement, we can convert aryl esters to ortho and para hydroxy ketones. Thank you very much.